Sarah Brown Wessling, thank you for coming on DBL. Okay, so you're a mom of three, a teacher, and named National Teacher of the Year in 2010. So what is your number one tip to help make remote learning just a little bit easier on everyone? Because it's a lot.
It is a lot for everyone, isn't it? So I think the first thing that we have to do is we really have to make sure we are focusing on the emotional, mental needs of all of our children, right? And so I think that starts with making sure that we keep in touch with our children, that we are kind of having some baseline conversations with them, really checking in to make sure we know how they're doing with all of these changes.
Very true. And here's the thing as well, you know, staying home all day, it can be depressing on the kids and on the parents. What tips do you have to keep their bodies and brains moving?
Yeah, so one of the things that teachers use a lot in their classrooms that I'm also using at home are called brain breaks, or some people call them vent activities, but it's just quick breaks. So it's not like you have to pack everybody up and go to the park and, you know, do all of that. It's like run up and down the stairs a couple of times. It might be, let's do some deep breathing. Sometimes we have to do that. Or it might be one of my children really likes a little fidget toy.
Yes.
I'm a big fan of those black binder clips, you know, just those cheap black binder clips. And sometimes that just helps, right, to get that frustration out.
That is some really good tips, and I love that they're easy, right? Because we all know how long it takes to pack everybody up and go to the park. Can you give us any simple ways to transform our spaces at home into a more productive and even attractive learning environment for our kids?
Yeah, I think what's most important is that there's just something consistent, and there's something that really works for your child. Two of my children like the kitchen table. I have one child who prefers like a comfy chair and a little lap desk, and he wants me to surprise him every morning and move it to a different place in the house so he can go find it. So whatever works, but consistency is really important.
I love your son. I love it. That's the way I would want to learn, in a comfy chair and move my environment around. Okay,
yeah.
So here's the thing, Sarah. Many parents, let's be real, they are managing full-time jobs on top of homeschooling. So what advice do you have for them to balance it all without getting overwhelmed, if that's even possible? I know a lot of us are overwhelmed.
We all are. So I think the first thing is kind of mindset. So I think we have to remember this is about progress and not perfection. And I think as parents, we have to really be as flexible as we can. The more flexible we can be with how we think about our time, with how we think about our expectations, I think the more we can use the time we have really productively. You know, it's so much better to have 25 or 30 really productive minutes than to try to have 3 hours that are a struggle, you know, all of the time.
Ain't that the truth? I love it. You seem like the queen of balance. You really do. You make it somehow digestible. I feel like that I can execute all of your advice, and I hope our DBL Nation can as well. Thank you for coming on DBL. Now, to DBL Nation, to learn more about Sarah and her homeschooling tips, you can check out sarahbrownwessling.com. Thank you again, Sarah. We'll be right back.
Thank you. Take care.